Subscribe my channel. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson. Today we are going to learn about another system of renal control. So that is RAAS. So renin-angiotensin aldosterone system. So this is an auto regulation mechanism in which renin is a hormone which is secreted by the juxtaglomerular apparatus. So where the juxtaglomerular apparatus is formed? So this is the ascending limb of the Henle's loop, and this is the distal convoluted tubule. When the distal convoluted tubule come into close contact of afferent renal arteriole, so this is the place where the afferent renal arteriole, and then this is distal convoluted tubule. So the contact of these two structures, here a specialized structure is present which is known as juxtaglomerular apparatus. So this juxtaglomerular apparatus consists of three types of special cells. So these are the cells. This is the DCT, distal convoluted tubule, TS. So these are the specialized cells of the DCT, which are known as macula densa cells. These macula densa cells can sense the sodium and potassium ions load in the renal fluid. So this is the afferent renal arteriole. So afferent renal arteriole consists of a specialized modified smooth cells. These modified smooth cells are baroreceptors. Baroreceptors means they sense the differences in the pressure. And so these release an hormone which is known as renin. So these cells are known as juxtaglomerular cells, and these cells by recognizing the difference in the blood pressure and also sodium and potassium levels, they secrete a hormone which is known as a renin hormone. And these are the cells which are in between the DCT and the glomerular arteries. Extraglomerular cells are lysis cells or Polkinson cells. So the function of these cells is not yet discovered. So these two cells, macula densa cell and juxtaglomerular cells, together form juxtaglomerular apparatus, which is useful for RAAS system, because juxtaglomerular cells secrete renin and also stores the hormone renin. How the juxtaglomerular apparatus controls the renal regulate? When the fluid from the ascending limb of the Henle reaches the distal convoluted tubule, so if at all it recognizes there is a increase in the sodium or potassium ions, so then it stimulate the smooth muscle cells of the juxtaglomerular cells to secrete renin into the circulation. So whenever this renin is circulated, so this is juxtaglomerular cells apparatus, whenever low BP or low glomerular blood flow or low glomerular filtrate rate occurs, so these three occurs when sodium and potassium ions concentration is more in the fluid. So then juxtaglomerular apparatus releases a hormone which is known as renin. So this renin hormone converts angiotensinogen. So this is a substance which is produced in the liver into angiotensin 1. So this angiotensin 1 is converted into angiotensin 2 in the presence of angiotensin converting enzyme. So this enzyme is abundantly present in the capillaries of the lungs. So this reaction mostly occurs when the blood flows through the capillaries of the lungs. So in this pandemic, ACE is become very popular because it is present even in our hands also. So the corona patients suffer from COVID-19 because this angiotensin converting enzyme binds to the virus molecule and help them to propagate, help them to enter into the body tissues and propagate inside the body. So that's why because ACE is abundantly present in the lungs, so lungs are mostly affected in the COVID patients. So coming to our renal control, so this ACE converts angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2, especially in the lung region. When angiotensin is formed, it stimulates the adrenal cortex, and which secretes a hormone which is known as aldosterone. So this aldosterone is a steroid hormone. It has two functions. So it stimulates the distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct to secrete potassium ions into the ducts, and it also influences the distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct to reabsorb water and sodium ions. As the water and sodium ions are reabsorbed and secretion of potassium ions occur, it automatically increases the blood pressure and consequently glomerular filtrate rate. So once these are established, once the BP is increased, so it leads to homeostasis, and that is the water balance. So water is reabsorbed, that's why the water balance is maintained. So the sodium ion concentration decreases. Whenever the sodium ion concentration decreases in the blood flow, it inhibits the juxtaglomerular apparatus. So it inhibits the juxtaglomerular apparatus. So as the juxtaglomerular apparatus is inhibited, renin is not produced. As the renin is not produced, all these reactions are not going to take place. These reactions are not going to take place. Next, so to check the RAS system, as a counter check to the RAS system, there is another system is present which is known as a natri diuretic factor or peptide system. So this factor is secreted by the heart region. So whenever the blood flow increases to the right atrium of heart, the walls of the heart stretches. As the right atrium walls stretches, it releases a atrium natri diuretic factor or peptide, simply we call as ANF. So this hormone causes vasodilation. Vasodilation means increase in the diameter of the blood vessels. As the diameter of the blood vessels increases, blood pressure is decreased, the distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct reabsorb more water. Like this, it counter checks the RAS system. Okay, hope you understand.